guys, welcome to Raina's Reality, where we step into reality with Raina. Today I am at Mercer County Park in the nice weather with my bro. Okay. And it is very nice outside, very windy. Not even windy. It's a nice breeze, you know, nice little sunlight. And today I'm going to be doing my long-awaited first Q&A video. Because, yeah, we need to get this YouTube shit going. So, I have a list of questions that my subscribers have given to me, and I have the answers to follow them. So, let's go. Let's start with questions that weren't even on the list, like regular basics. So, my name is Raina. I am 19. My birthday is August 13th, 2003. That's why it says it on the necklace. I was born in New Brunswick, New Jersey. And
My name is Anthony.
No one asked. I am Puerto Rican and black. My mother is Puerto Rican and black, and my dad is black.
My name is Anthony.
We didn't ask. Okay.
What was I looking
so, at? So, what else about me that's not
look
on the list?
Look at those cross runners.
Look. So, I am very fashionable, as you see.
Okay. The Jordans on the feet.
Wait, but guys, I'm also fashionable because this is part of my YouTube channel, too.
It is
part of the foam runners on the feet, the shirt, the cargo pants.
Okay, guys, so I have to give him an uncredited feature in my videos. So
okay, Martin Luther King, you better give your speech.
Back to the real list here. So.
Wait, let me read the question. First question, who is your go-to person when in need, besides family?
You already fucked up. My go-to person besides family is my best friend, Key. And we have actually met in middle school. I'm going into my second year of college. We met in like my first year of middle school. And we always were like really close and always like hit it off. And we just always had that friendship. There was like always a friendship, and I trusted with my whole heart.
Okay, question number two. How did your brother get the name Bud, which is me?
Bud got the name when I was young. Like, he used to always follow me around the house. I'm 19, he'll be 17 in January of next year. So 3 years technically apart.
No, we're actually
months.
2 years and like 7 months or yeah. Something, 8 months.
Like, we've always been close, out the womb. Always hit it off, like, yeah, we're locked in. And we were very close during childhood. We played with each other all the time. Like, that's really the homie. Like, that's the other half.
Okay, next really. Question.
So basically, he got the name Bud because he used to always follow me around the house when I was
playing.
Like, I'll be like
basically,
walking around, chilling, doing my own, you know, little
house,
girl
and
stuff.
To say, come and here, buddy, let's go. So thank that's you. How he got the name Bud. Thank you.
And he'll just be behind me, like, trailing me. I'm like, bro, like.
Question three. What is the name of your car? Which, it was my inspiration, by the way.
Ah, guys, I just got my car.
You have to say it. It was my
camera. Roll the camera. Last Thursday, last week, September 1st. And I named her V. Now, V is a Volkswagen Jetta. And V is also the name of my grandmother that passed in 2017. Yeah. So she's a 17. My grandma passed a 17, so it's ironic. So her name is V. And I love her. Just like I love my grandmother. We love V the car. We love V the lady.
They're really pretty.
Question four, okay, roll right along. We got, what is your...
Bro, relax. It's just a name.
Name. Say your real middle name.
My middle name is Antoinette.
Good.
Like the queen.
That's what I like to hear.
Wasn't she a queen? Queen Antoinette? Whatever. name. Both of my siblings have middle names that are incorporated with my father. So my father's name is Troy Anthony. The first, he's Troy Anthony Davis the second. My sister's middle name, she gonna see this too.
Loser.
My sister's middle name is Troy with an I at the end. My dad and his is with a Y on the end. And mine is Antoinette because like Anthony is shit. My saint name, actually when I made confirmation in eighth grade at church, my saint name is Gabrielle. I actually like that better than my birth name because what the fuck is Antoinette? That's like old lady shit. So I'm like,
no. Embrace it.
I don't want to.
Embrace it.
No. Clips. Roll the clips.
Question 5. What's your dream job?
My dream job is detective. I want to be a homicide detective or a missing persons detective.
Missing people.
Persons. Persons.
Or people.
There is a question about my college major. So we'll get back to that, but that's my future job. If I don't change, that's up right now.
Next, we got number 6. How many kids do you want? How many kids do you desire?
Why are you just
turning
his back on me? That's so rude.
3 or 4. I love kids. Little background, I used to work at a daycare, and I absolutely loved it. The only reason I left was because it got overwhelming. Working with kids is not for the weak. It's very overwhelming. It's very stressful, especially if you're by yourself with kids. Yeah. I was put in rooms alone with at least 15, 20 kids at once. And I got tired of it. But I love kids. I absolutely adore kids. As a young kid myself, I loved kids. I see babies and they take a liking to me. Like, these little babies out here are my besties. Like, we're locked in for life. Just like him. We locked in. He attracted to me when I was a baby. He used to trail me. These kids trail me, okay?
She trails me too.
What?
Number 7. Favorite cuisine or restaurant?
My favorite cuisine gotta be Italian. Like, I love Italian food. Like, I'm literally Italian, bro. I'm literally from Italy. Like, I was literally born in Italy. Like, literally. Favorite restaurant is probably Olive Garden. Like, I love Olive Garden. Like, the inside, like, the decor, just, it gives
I don't know what the
like,
mind
giving,
picture
like,
was at that point, but I don't think I debuted
Italy,
that
like,
very
under
well.
Bridges
my
and
dad.
Shit. Yeah, that's what it's giving. I absolutely love Italian food. I am a very picky eater. I can't just eat anything. Also allergic to garlic, like fresh garlic. Sometimes garlic powder, like it depends. Like my taste buds are weird. I just live. I'm also allergic to shellfish, but I don't like seafood at all. Like I hate seafood. Never take me to a seafood, but don't take me to crab du jour. Don't take me to Red Lobster. Don't take me to, I'll stay home. I'll vote to stay home. And I love to go out, but I will vote and vouch to stay home. I hate seafood. And I'm also allergic to peanuts since I was young. Oh, there's a story when I was young, allergic to peanut butter. Roll the clips. Oh, we were young, very young. And I remember vividly that it was a rental car. And I forgot where the rental car was. It was me and my whole family. We were in this car. And I forgot where we were going, where we were coming from, but I remember when we were in the car close to my house, my mom had gave me peanut M&Ms out of her bag. So me being a kid, I'm like, yo, you wanna share some? And of course she gonna share some because, so we did an experiment. I had some, I don't remember how I was feeling because you know, I was young, I have memory like Dory. And then as soon as we pulled up outside of our house, we didn't even get in. It was outside the driveway. I threw up all over the car. It was a rental car. It was new. It was not ours. I threw up all over the place. I'm like, that's it. I'm allergic to peanuts. My mom made the discovery that day. We all made the discovery. And they had the job of cleaning the car. And I had the job of discovering that I'm allergic to peanuts. So, yeah. Sorry, guys. Brief intermission. I was playing.
Why you come over here like you got to jump the camera?
I say hi to my nephew and my sister. Yeah. Hi. Say hi.
page of scenery under the nice big tree.
I'm just gonna continue on like you ain't just damaged okay. Mother Nature.
Question. All right, it's getting a little windy, boys. So, question 8. What made you get into YouTube?
Me, I have the personality for YouTube, and I'm not going to say it's always something I wanted to do, because I'm not going to say I grew up camera shy, because I grew up in front of cameras. Like, I used to be a dancer and, you know, recitals and shit. YouTube, though, a lot of my friends were telling me I have the personality for it. I'm always on my close friends on Instagram, just doing this. Like, I'm always talking, ranting, anything. And a lot of my friends are telling me, like, I should start a YouTube, make a vlog. Like, they'll subscribe and support. And I'm like, all right, so I'm going to go for it. And here we are.
Question 9. Anything you would like to tell
yourself?
Wait
a second. What did he just start grooving to?
Self-motivation. Like,
always smile and keep your head. Because why are we being negative when we could die tomorrow? The world can cease to exist tomorrow. Like, anybody can fucking die tomorrow. Negativity is not for me anymore. Like, I've had my time of negativity. I've had my time to be sad and depressed. I'm not doing that anymore. So, advice to my future self, keep a smile on your face, babes. The storm stops. The storm don't last forever.
It's far from over.
Rolling?
Yeah, we rolling. Let's go. All right. Number 10. Who's your biggest inspiration or role model?
I don't have one.
Actually,
I don't have one.
I'm one of her inspirations.
No, you're not.
She would love to be like me.
No.
He ain't show up. Thank you for lesson, man. I had to grow up. That's why I never ask for help. I do it for your niggas and do it for myself. I go 0 to 100, nigga, real quick. Real quick, whole squad on that real shit.
Hey guys, yeah. Change of scenery again.
Yeah.
For the sixth time.
We have to make a little drive. Number 12, biggest fear.
Thunder. I hate thunder. No, not thunder. Lightning. Lightning. Thunder and lightning and bridges. Like driving over bridges. You won't catch me on a bridge. And if you do catch me on a bridge, my head's probably down. Hate bridges and thunder and lightning. No.
13, what do you look for in a relationship?
Ooh, this is a good one. Okay, basically, mostly I go for personality. I go for personality. If you're funny, like me, if you could be funnier than me, then you automatically got my
yep,
heart.
There's
like,
me.
It's no right funnier. Top. Like, here's me at the top, and there's literally nothing else at the top. Like, I'm at the top. Like, I'm funny. As funny as they come. So, if you're, like, on top of me, we can get married tomorrow.
A little elaboration.
A lot of people who are older than me.
When I say old, I mean a couple to
if
a few
to get
years
tomorrow,
older than
what?
Me. I don't want any
I love older
grandfathers in nursing homes trying to text me. No, sir. No.
You got to be older than me. More mature. You have to, like, have goals and have something going for yourself. I hate, like, a drug dealer, a scammer, somebody who's locked up, somebody who got kids. Keep all them out the picture with me.
Side note.
It's me or
my
nothing.
Tattoo says
tattoo. I love
the
a man
eye
with tattoos.
Is a semicolon. The semicolon means to keep going, and the whole idea behind the tattoo is for suicide awareness.
I love a man with tattoos. You just gotta have something going for yourself. Like, you can't be a bum sitting on your ass all day. Like, what? We're too old. How are you gonna make money? How are you gonna spoil me when I ask for a pair of Uggs? You can't. If you're sitting on your ass 24/7, how am I gonna get the shoes that I want? You're not like, and mostly I go for Hispanics, but black, white, purple, green, Mexican, it don't matter. You just gotta have a good personality. Be back, guys. Brief intermission. Welcome to my backyard.
Unfortunately, I have no pool. I am an aquatic person. That is another thing about me. I love water.
Just to put it out there, this video is not sponsored. I definitely choose the pool over. Please just let him talk and live. Nobody asked that. World.
I love water.
This video is sponsored by Yeezy. Get your Yeezys today. This video is also sponsored by Macy's. Get your cargo pants today. And lastly, this video is sponsored by Shein. Back to the video.
I'm
number
ready.
14, favorite rap artist.
We know. Rod Wave. He, y'all may not consider him a rap artist, but I do. We do. It's Rod or nobody. I also am a diehard Chris Brown fan. Old Chris Brown slaps. His new album that came out a few months ago is all right. But anything he makes, he just has really... That was Drake. He just has really good bars, lines. Like, I love Chris Brown. I've always loved him from when he first started music. He don't even got to be considered a rap artist. I will go hard for Chris Brown. I also like Drake. Old Drake, especially. Like, I can't stand his new shit.
You just had your moment.
New shit sucks. Drake, if you see this... You suck. Yeah, his old music. I also love the Queen, Nicki Minaj. You can never go hard in the paint as much as Nicki does. Because Nicki, she don't care. She'll say it in a song. She will put it in a song. Anything, any little thing, she'll put it in a song. She goes hard. And Pop Smoke, of course. Long live my baby. Woo back.
Number 15. Favorite show?
Pretty Little Liars. Pretty Little Liars, I always love that show. Always. I don't care how old it is, how many times I watched the whole series, I love Pretty Little Liars.
I definitely recommend Bel-Air, though.
You never even finished it.
Yes, I did. It's only one season so far. They gotta come out with another season.
Okay. Here's an airplane.
Place that you want to travel to.
But
Barcelona,
where I've been. I've been
Santorini,
Paris,
Greece, and Cabo.
And I cruised to the
I'm not telling y'all my trips planned.
Also been to a handful of the 50 states. I've been to California. I've definitely been to Florida, the Carolinas, to name a few.
That I already have planned. Because y'all...
What you mean, me too?
We'll see.
You're scared of
YouTube
roller coasters.
Is going on a
that
journey
in
a mission with me,
I'm the
okay?
Type to
I'm a very adventurous person.
Don't play with me.
I would love to travel the world. There's a few places that I don't care to go to, but that'll be in another video. But those are my top three as of right now.
Number 17. How old were you when you got your first, when you had your first kiss?
My first kiss? That was probably like in middle school sometime. I don't know like exact age. Like I said, I have memory of Dory. Like, I don't remember. I honestly can't answer that question because I was young. I can't say elementary school, but I can say middle school, but I just don't remember. Can't remember like exact age, exact grade, you know, like exact person. Maybe if I, you know, cut down the list a little bit, you know, think, but I can't right now. So.
Number 18. What is your favorite thing to talk about?
Myself. If y'all haven't.
Narcissistic.
Yes, I love to talk about myself because I just feel like...
She's a narcissist, like I said.
Okay, whatever. I just love to talk about myself. Like, I can go on and on. Like, I have stories from years, days, weeks. Like, I don't care. I have so much to talk about. And I live a pretty interesting life. And if I'm not talking about myself, I'm probably talking about my nephew.
Or Bud.
My heart. And I love talking. Like, I love just... talking and letting everything out. Like, if you don't like look in your mirror and just talk and have a conversation with yourself, what are you doing? You're just a boring person and you need help.
Next, number 19. Favorite food?
Anything with chicken. Like, I know I said Italian food earlier, but I love chicken.
any type of chicken. Barbecue, fried, nuggets, tenders, wings. Wings, they gotta be flats, though. I don't care. I don't eat... They gotta be flats. Chicken sandwich, anything. I love chicken. Protein. I'm a big protein girl. And besides chicken, I am a snacker. I'm a huge snacker. My favorite snacks are Rice Krispie Treats, Cheez-Its, and the red Doritos. And I'm a big water drinker. I love water. Ice water.
Question number 20. Have you watched P-Valley?
P-Valley? No. I heard it was like a show about like prostitution. But never got into
it. It's the black people show. Where do you see yourself in 5 years?
Myself in 5 years.
Where do you see yourself in 5 years? Where do you see yourself in 10 years? And where do you see yourself in 20 years?
Okay, 5 years. I'm not going to lie. I'm not going to lie on here. In 5 years, I probably see myself pregnant or with a kid. That's 5 years for me. Also on the side, 5 years, I'm going to be still doing YouTube. I'm still going to be involved and getting my name out there. 5 years, I am going to stay motivated. Like, my goals will stay there. 5 years, I definitely see myself with my name out there, getting known. 10 years, I see myself, like, traveling. Like, I am out. 10 years, I want to be committed in a relationship or married. Like, I don't want to do anything old, because I feel like if you're young where you do all these things, then you get to live your life with your kids, you know, like with your husband, with like y'all buying a house together, y'all doing.
You're gonna have a kid at 60 years old.
There's people that do that, but that's not gonna be me. I would like to have my kid in the next 5 years, because like I said, I don't want to be an old ass mom. Like, I just feel like I want to be a young mom. Like, people gonna look at me like, damn, she looks young. Yeah, because that's because I am. Like, 20 years, definitely settled down, got myself together, got my career going. Even at 10 years, I said 10. Even at 10 years, I want to have my career, like, already in my career, already up there. But actually, disclaimer, I'm in my second year right now of criminal justice. I actually just changed my major, so this is technically my first semester of criminal justice, but my second year at college. But to be a detective, you gotta have 5 years of like basic cop experience. So unfortunately, that's where I will be in the next 5 years. But that's okay. Goals. That was my Q&A. Thank you guys for listening. And don't be a stranger, because these videos will be coming regularly at this point. I hope y'all tell a friend to tell a friend to tell a friend. I hope y'all like.
Tell your grandma's thumbs best up. Long lost friend.
Tell your cousin's cat's neighbor to subscribe. You know, give me thumbs up and everything. We will be active. And this is not the first time. This is not the first or last time y'all will be seeing us.
Yes. The next video is centered around me.
No, it's not. Bye, guys. I'm a party with the real Madonna. Feet, eyes, do numbers, and remain humble. Tap, tap, brushes.